staring up in the all 3 feet of his pudding face grandeur, and I say, Dylan, you've been in this class for 3 years, and you still don't know if I'm a boy or a girl? Well, then at this point, I really don't think it matters to you. No. Can I have a push on the swing? And this happens every day. It's a tidal wave of kindergarten curiosity rushing straight for the rocks of me, whatever I am. In the classroom, we discuss the Milky Way galaxy, the orbit of the sun around the Earth, or whatever, Jupiter, Saturn, Mars, and kids, do you know that some of the stars we see when we look up in the sky are so far away they've already burned out? What do you think of that, Timmy? My mom says that even though you got hairs that grow from your legs and that the hairs on your head grow short and pokey and that you smell really bad like my dad, that you're a girl. Thank you, Timmy! And so it goes. On the playground, she peers up from behind her pink powder puff sunglasses and asks, do you have a boyfriend? And I say, no. And she says, oh. Do you have a girlfriend? And I say, no. But if by some miracle 20 years from now I ever finally do, then I'll definitely bring her by to meet you. How's that? Okay, can I have a push in the swing? And that's the thing. They don't care. They don't care. Us, on the other hand. My father, sitting across the table at Christmas dinner, gritting his teeth over his skillful plate, his appetite ripped away by the intrusion of my haircut. What were you thinking? You used to be such a pretty girl. College boys, drunk and screaming, leaning out the window of their daddy's SUVs. Hey, are you a faggot or a dyke? And I wonder what would happen if I met up with them in the middle of the night. Then, of course, there's always the somehow not quite bright enough fluorescent light of the public restroom. Sir, do you realize this is a ladies' room? Yes, ma'am, I do. It's just I didn't feel comfortable sticking this tampon up my penis in the men's room. But the best is always the parents at the market. The mother sticking up her nose while the father pushes aside his child's wide eyes, whispering, don't stare, it's rude. And I want to say, listen, dude, the only rude thing I see is your paranoid parental hand pushing aside the best education on self that little kid's ever going to get, even with your pinks and blues, your boy girl rules. So why don't you take your macho and shove it in that car with your wife's fucking issue of Cosmo? Because tomorrow, I start my day with 28 miles and know a hell of a lot more than you. And if I show up in a pink fully dressed, those kids won't love me any more or less. Hey, are you a boy or a... Oh, never mind. Can I have a push in the swing? And someday, y'all, when we grow up, it's all going to be that simple. Thank you.